Welcome back to another edition of Dante's PvP Souls. That's right, I'm back, and yet with another Ashes of Ariandel DLC weapon, Friede's Great Scythe plus 5. Now, if you didn't know, I boosted my character in certain areas, like Dexterity. You're welcome, Revan619. Vigor is 40. I think I boosted that slightly. Endurance, same as 40. Vitality, I actually made a little bit lower, and of course, I had to add some Intelligence and Faith. Now, I'm going more of the physical damage with this rather than the intelligence magic damage. It could make this weapon slightly weaker, but I'd rather have the stats in other areas. So, I don't know, give and take. I don't know. It could do, I'm sure it does more damage if you have more intelligence. But again, I'm going more physical power rather than intelligence power and physical with dexterity, if you get what I mean. Anyways, I'm using the Lothric Knight Helm, Lorien Armor, Lothric Knight Gauntlets, and Katarina Leggings just because it fits under the 70% encumbrance. Atlas Ring plus 2 because I have less vitality. Sun Princess Ring because whatever. Chloranthi Ring and Ring of Favor, ladies and gentlemen. This weapon is interesting. Can do frost damage, but it seems unlikely because it is a scythe. However, has some interesting properties, as you will see in the coming fights. I actually, unfortunately, I already recorded like 12, 13 fights or something like that. And then something happened, the recording got messed up, and I'm very upset because I had some cool fights in there. But I'm here, and I'm going to do it again, ladies and gentlemen, because damn it. Anyways, if you don't already know, I don't buff my character, don't buff my weapon. I'll do about 10 fights in the Pontiff Sullivan area. Sometimes I might go elsewhere, but it's generally Pontiff is the biggest area, and then maybe High Wall is the second biggest, but there's not many people at High Wall unless someone specifically wants to start a fight club there, which is common-ish, but usually a password protected. So, let's see how I do! Round one against Black Moth. Oh, please heal up all the way. He's not going to. I know he's not. Damn it. Annoying. Come on. Woo. Really? Ha. Oh, what the hell? I must have ran out of stamina. Get dead! Wow, what a close fight, actually. GG, that was a good fight. That guy did a lot more damage than I expected with his weapon there. Wow, that was a pretty good fight. First fight, starting off good. Wow. Round two against Painted Phantoms. I'm excited. Seeing the way this guy plays. What the? Oh, nice. He got me good. Woo! Oh! Oh, man. Oh, I didn't think that would kill me. That was dumb by me. Damn it. That was a good fight, too. That was actually a pretty good fight, and I blew it at the end. Yeah, I just blew it. I didn't roll because I'm like, oh, I'm out of range. Why would I do that? That was stupid. Wow. That was a good fight. That was fun. That was actually pretty fun. Round three against Armani. That's me. Armani. His helmet looks, or is that just his face? Does he not have a helmet? What the hell is he doing? All right, what's going on? Power up. Oh, I'm not sure if you can parry that. Flawless. I mean, I figured I tried. If he parried me, even if he had Hornet Ring, I shouldn't be dead. So I figured, why not go for it? Flawless. Thank you, and good night. Round 4 against Ekuro. What the hell? Their health got diminished? They were at full health, weren't they? Wow, that actually hit me. I'll take it. Woo! Come on, I'll do it too. Get dead. I'll do it. And I'll do it all day. Alright, round 5. Nizu the Cursed. What's going on, buddy? Oh. I am shocked I got hit there. Really? He was able to get out of that quick. Alright, throw your fireballs. Really? Oh! He recovered extremely fast. Jesus Christ. He recovered extremely fast after that hit. What the hell was that about? That's something I still don't understand. He, like, hit me. I couldn't even roll. That was weird. That was weird. Damn, he got me, though. That stupid fire thing. He got me on that R2 thing, which is something that I've utilized so well, and I get caught on it. Not many people have even used straight swords anymore. At least not one like that. Not one that's not a dark sword. So that, it's not something I'm even used to playing against, which is interesting. Round 6? Against Sparrow, I think. I think it's 6 or 7. I don't know. Really? That was awesome. Keep jumping over him. Ooh, nice. Whatever. He tried it. He failed. I'll take it. Not my problem. Not my problem. Could have been if he got it, though. I think he tried to reactive parry, and that's not how that works, as far as I understand. Anyways, round 7 or 8 against Sailor Unanoki. Unanoki. Ooh. Come on. Ow. Get dead. I'll take it. I'll take all the wins. Who am I kidding? Oh, man. Anyways, next up, round 8 or something against, did I fight this? Oh, Black Moth. Oh, we had a good fight, actually. This is going to be interesting. Come on. Man, it's just slightly faster. Whoa! What the hell? Am I missing? Wow. Another close fight. Obviously, the connection was a little bit weird. Wow. I got lucky. That jump attack looked way early. That. Whew. Okay. Oh, man. All right. Okay. I wonder if you have more range one-handed with this. I'm very curious. Round 10 or something against Cutlass Supreme. Yeah, because if you do that, look, see, I don't know. You might have more range with the one-handed. That I'm not sure about. Come on, Cutlass. What do you got? Flawless victory. And I will take it. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and germs, I'm in. Let's keep going. Let's keep blowing people's minds with just raw fortitude. Round 11-ish against Peastry. All right, what's going on? Hello. Every time I move and I miss it somehow. I'll take it. Boom! I will definitely just love that win. Oh, here we go. Now the final boss. Hey, Cinnamon Sticks! Cinnamon Sticks is here! Oh, crap. Here we go. All right, he did a lot of damage to me. He swiped a lot. Get dead. Ah, man, that jump attack, pretty sexy. I'll be honest, the two tap drap. Round 13 or something against Poo-Rory. Poo-Rory. Winnie the Poopies. All right, what do you got? Bring it. I ran out of juice. He wants to parry me so bad. Flawless victory. That's what happens. You just spam and you win. Ladies and gentlemen, that was terrible. Oh, God. Round blop of the beeps. 14 or something like that, I thinkers. I'm not sure. Whatever. That sucked. Damn it. I did hit him with a lot. Get that. Oh, man. It gets him every time, ladies and gentlemen. Delicious. Nutritious. I'm in. Chilla is next. Chia. Chia patch. Maybe it is Chia. Oh, he's got the pike or something. What the hell is this? Wow. Okay. I'll take it. I bait him into it. That's good on me, I'll tell you that. Got him into it, man. The setup. What's going on, Mathor? Mathor's got a scythe. A reaper. I'm sorry, a reaper. And I'm excited. We both tried the same thing. Oh! Ha! Suck knife! Oh, wow. Damn. All right, okay. I like how I missed. All right, Mathor. What the hell? The hit detection was absurd right there. Ah. Mathor! Alright, good. I spaced that perfectly. I'm happy, too, because that was annoying. In the beginning, it was fine, and then, like, things were very slow. Round something against Dengro! Dengro FF. What does he have? What is that? Come on. Dengro! Jesus Christ, man. So lucky. There we go. I thought he was dead, actually, earlier on. I guess it was my fault for overswinging and letting my back in there. Whatever, I still won. Who cares? Who cares? What do we got next? Taco, bro! I'm in. I love tacos. My favorite food, actually. Fun fact, in case you didn't know about it. Ortega tacos, to be exact. All right, what's he got? Of course. Why wouldn't I miss? Ooh, how did he have stamina left? Really? There we go. I'll take it. I've been taking a lot of these. Am I right? Am I right, Mother Trucker? Whoa! Hello! Felipe 1411! He's from the 15th century. What does he have? Back up, Savage. I don't know what's going on here. I love how I thought I moved. Back up, Savage. Oh! I didn't think I was going to hit him, so that's why I didn't strike twice. Oh, I wanted it. He's playing the wait and see game, but he's not playing it well. Oh, whatever. Haha, get hit. 17 damage. Really? You're going to block with that? Get dead. Too quick for you. Oh, man. Next up, did I fight this guy? Dubby! U62. I did fight this guy, didn't I? We got a rematch, which is fine. Nice. Got him with a lot of dips right there. What is this? That's a combo that hurts. I'll tell you what. I am just decimating people. They say, although it is at technically taking 1/10 off of whatever I say it is, but whatever. Deci, deci, whatever. You get what I'm saying, all right? Words, that's how they work. Thank you, Latin. Thank you. Round something against Schauzermeister. Schauzermeister? I'll back up from that. That seems dangerous. Whoa! This guy, he is straight up. Man. I just need one hit. Come on. Come on. Show me that smiling face. Jesus Christ. From the moon! The moon! Alright, who is this? Zig Fox. Did I fight this guy earlier? And lose? I don't know. I can't remember. But he's got the weapon. The skills. Come on. He did more damage to me, which is dumb. Ow. Oh. I don't know why he tried to block that. This has magic on it. That was their fault. Alright, Chauncey Von Jaxi. Let's do this. What's going on, buddy? I'm a hypocrite here, because I always talk about how you want to fight with full life. Ah, damn it. He's going to do a lot of damage to me. I feel it. Oh! Ah. I'll take it. Woo! Chauncey Von Jaxi. Come on. Are you scared? Ooh, nice spacing. I mean, it was a little bit off. Here, I'd get him there. Oh! Look at that. Like, do anything. There we go. Jeez. They were not doing anything. Not even a... That wasn't... That was weird. All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, round something. French Dickler is here! French Dickler. What do they have? What the hell is that? Okay, all right, just checking. Come on, strike one more time. One more time. Oh, I don't know about that one. That was a little bit strange. Really? I don't know how the hell I missed. I'm getting my ass whooped. I'll do it twice. I gotta get my damn stamina back. Ah. Oh, nice. I thought I would hit him before he did it. I could have won that, I feel like. He got me much more with the bigger weapon, which is ridiculous. What the hell? Why was I getting just bombarded by hate? Because I was there for so damn long, crushing everybody? Ah. Round something. Against... Why can't things work? Thank you. Against Katin a Gamer. Oh, I'm an idiot. Katana Gamer. All right, here we go. Come on, Katana Gamer. Really? I didn't hit him there? That was extremely quick the way I did that. That was ridiculous. That was stupid. Wow. What the hell? Wow. I don't understand. He tried it again. I punished him. Wow. I punished him for it, but he didn't die. Incredible. There you go. Get dead. I don't know how I didn't hit them, by the way, before. That was absurd. It's deceiving. The range on this thing is definitely deceiving. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. That's what we're going with. Braid, Great Scythe, you're dead to me. You are dead to me now. The damage is interesting. The damage is actually pretty decent. It's decent. And it's weird, though, because... When you do the weapon art, the R1 rep weapon art, it doesn't do much, but it does something. Like, I don't even understand. Like, am I missing on some of the attacks or something? I don't know. It felt like some people were taking much more damage than others. But anyways, the damage is actually pretty decent on this. I'm going to give it an 8.7. As far as the moveset, it's a Scythe. I don't hate the Scythe moveset. I really don't. There's a time and place for it, and obviously there's a way to not use it. but, you know, R1, R2, like, it's got an interesting moveset. That is bad, but it's good for roll-catching people, like, who's trying to go around you. It's weird. I still think Scythes, or Reapers, really, are underutilized. I think they are better than people give it credit for. I think part of the issue is the learning curve. It might be the highest learning curve of any weapon in the game. Just because you have to play it in such a specific way. Like the one-handed, like, I didn't do it in this video, but in the other one that got lost early on, that the corrupted file. Every now and then I would roll around R1, or one-handed, and do this and switch it up because they didn't expect that. They expected the slower version. And the slower version can roll catch people, but if you flip-flop, you can get them every now and then. I mean, it's just how it goes, and that's the roll R2, and I don't know, it's interesting. The moveset is only as bad as the distance and speed, sort of. It's... Reapers might have the most interesting thing. I think if you're good, really good, and this is excluding super wait and see players, although actually this does prey a little bit upon wait and see players because of its interesting timings. But aside from wait and see players, which I sort of have to take them away from this type of formula I have, and I think you can roll catch and get people pretty good. I mean, the jumping attack is really good for roll catch people. You saw I got a bunch of people with the swipe, and jump attack. A bunch. So it's interesting. It's definitely interesting. I don't know. And this even actually has... I probably didn't even need to do the jumping attack. I could probably do the third swipe, which some people seem to understand a little bit. So I don't know. The moveset, I really do like the moveset. I think if you got really expert at this weapon, it can be extremely deadly. Extremely deadly. So I'm going to give the moveset 8.9. I do like it. I don't know. And I said this about the other scythe I did. I really think it's underutilized. I think it's underrated. Again. Now, this one, I think, is better than the others only because of the weapon skill, which I'm about to hit up right now. But the weapon skill is just absurd. And there's a few reasons why it's absurd. Now, firstly, I like this R2 weapon skill because it sort of gives you space. It's like, okay, let me get space for whatever reason you're doing it. Unless you're going against, obviously, like a mage, someone who can shoot you. But if you're not, you can usually scare somebody enough where they won't try to attack you. Now, I will attack somebody and then roll away because it's pretty slow. I mean, at least when it activates. It's not instant. But it does make most people not even want to chance it because why would you? So you can get your stamina back. You can recover. You can basically just refresh yourself and try to be like, all right, let's do this. Let's see what we can do. I love it. Now, for the real star of the show is the weapon skill L2 R1. Are you kidding me? Firstly, the weapon skill has hyper armor, which is absurd for this type of weapon skill. I mean, for you do the jump forward, so you have pretty decent distance and range on it, and you have hyper armor. But ridiculously, at least to me, I think it's ridiculous, is that it takes no FP. Like, what the hell? That is absurd to me. No FP. Zero FP or very little. Like, am I like, I don't even understand. I have 21. Let's see, does it take just extremely small amounts? No, it doesn't. It's absurd. It's one of the best in the entire game by far. Just zero F. Like, what? That's so ridiculous to me. I think is actually a little bit broken. I do think that taking no FP is broken. That's crazy to me. And if your character was a little bit more magic, or if you... I don't know. There's ways to make people get frosted. If you... I don't know. There's like, if you do the weird frost... whatever, the new spell that makes like a frost wave or whatever, and then you can catch somebody in this combo, that's deadly. But the chances of that happening are very low. Anyways, the weapon skill... I think I'm going to give it a 9.5. It is up there as one of, if not the best, because of very just hyper armor, the amount of hits you can get. You can't get that last hit usually. What's cool, though, is if you miss, you whiff on the first two and then hit them on the second, you do get that last hit. And it's good for roll punishing, and people know it's happening. However, the problem with the weapon skill... again, which seems to be a common problem, is if people are too close, you just go past them and you miss them. And that happened to me a bunch of times. So that's interesting. Anyways, as far as the viability, again, I think Reapers are underutilized, underused, and I think they're a lot better than people give it credit for. I think an expert would actually be a contender. I really do think that. I really do. And especially with this, with the hyper armor, I do think, unless... obviously, wait and see. That's the issue. It's always wait and see players. People in the wait and see tribe This weapon is too slow for wait and see. You can maybe get some trickery hits here or there, but it's not going to be enough to kill him. So wait and see, aside from wait and see, trash. I think it's viable. I do. I'm going to give it a 9.2. I think if you're really good, it's really viable. Especially if you're really good at with it and you're an expert. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this one. Like, comment, and subscribe. Tell me what you think, and I will be back.